those road classes.
For 4.1.1, to show primary resources for evidence, some primary sources for literary studies, the arts and history are like diaries, letters, images and films, etc. And mainly look for a primary source because it has a higher chance of being a credible source. And they provide data in form of words, images, and sounds that can use as evidence that you can use as evidence to support your reasons. So basically talks about how,
like, how primary sources are the things you mainly want to look for when you're doing your art.
Secondary sources to learn about your topic. Scholarly books and articles written for other researchers uses data from primary sources as evidence. Number one, to substitute for unavailable primary sources. Basically, if there are no primary sources available, you try to look for most reliable secondary sources. Number two, to learn what others have written about your book. Basically, you look at other articles and you compare their evidence to yours. Number three, to find models for your own writing and art papers. You basically have to have the same structure. So if, for example, an article has like short paragraphs, you most likely have to have short paragraphs. And number four, to find opposing points of views, you have to look for other perspectives, like how other people see or like how they think about the article.
So my section is 4.1.3, which is read tertiary sources for introductory overviews. So basically, tertiary sources are based on secondary sources. Usually for specialists. Examples like encyclopedias, dictionaries, magazines, newspaper articles, and commercial books written for a general audience. But you're gonna wanna be cautious when using data from magazines, newspaper articles, and tertiary sources from the web, because some researchers say that the data they found is either reliable, but it can also be like oversimplified and or they can misreport it or misinterpret. Thank you. That concludes my presentation.